Hey guys, welcome back to World of Tanks. Today I'm featuring one of my recent battles. I've been playing the Baguette 25 TAP, the tier 9 French medium tank, which is more like a tier 8 upgraded scout. I had loads of fun driving this one, and just a few hours ago I bought the tier 10, so my grind is over for this one. I kept it in the garage. I intend to train a new crew for it and have the occasional game with it, because I really enjoyed playing this. This was so much fun. This game particularly is not the highest damage game I've done with it. I had games where I expended all my ammunition, coming close to 6,000 damage. They were not as good as far as the end game goes as this one. Most of them, of those games, ended up being defeats or draws. This one, spoiler, is gonna be a win. There's plenty of arties in play. We have 3 on our team, I believe. The enemy team has 4. At this point I did not realize one of them was a tier 5, the LEF. On a failed platoon, I just noticed the icons. I paid no attention to what it was, so I took this forward position trying to spot stuff in the middle and get some shots in. I got spotted coming up, so I stayed close to the rock formations. I took a few blind shots here. This is a common mistake, and believe me, over 100 battles on this tank did not make me do this less. Actually, I was considering blind firing again there, and the common mistake I was talking about was blind firing that tank destroyer. I keep forgetting about the low amount of ammunition this tank carries. Only 30 rounds, that's 5 clips. Or magazines, whatever you want to call it. So I was considering blind firing, well, the usual tank destroyer position, but the SU-100M1 just drove forward, and I was happy to unload the damaging shell on it. So I'm gonna reload. I keep taking ticks here, trying to see if I get spotted or if I spot anything. I don't. And at this point I'm gonna look around, and it looks like this flank is alright, but on our left, the beach side, things don't look like they're going smoothly, so I just get out of there, and I'm gonna get on an overlook position or overwatch position, so I can empty on those guys. Try to find a shot on that guy in the middle. I didn't really add it, didn't lose any more time. And right here I considered going into that little rock formation on the right hand side of the cap, and then my brain factored in the RTs, and as soon as I got spotted there, maybe I would have gotten shot straight away by RT, by artillery fire. So since they're on the beach and I've got a more advantageous position from here, I'm going to try and find shots from here. We're gonna take out that T-34. I get spotted. I do hang about for a little bit too long. I should have gotten out there earlier, but I saw the 54E1 advancing, so I get the kill with a blind shot. And now I'm going towards the middle. I'm gonna try and take out the M41 and help these guys in the middle. I'm gonna look for the shot here, but I shouldn't have stopped there. There was like less than 5% chance that guy would go around the corner, and right now we're losing 610. I took the M41 out, I take the M1 out. But we're still losing. 8-10. RT has a go at me. I spot the 152 there, which I believe is the SU. No, it's the ISU. The preview is too small for me to read text models. I must do it from memory or just take a look at the replay just before I start commenting on it. The bat chat is around the middle, and I opted to reload because I had only one shell. So I'm gonna go out and around, and I do spot the T-43 in the middle part of the map. I'm not loaded, I didn't get spotted, there's no point staying there. I was aiming right now to take out the bat chat before I could get to my artillery support. And now I'm gonna make a huge mistake just after I get my next shot in. I'm gonna get this shot into the bat chat. And he's now one shot. I get stuck trying to reverse around the rocks. I just wanted to be safe so I wouldn't get spotted going when it drove between those hills. But then the ISU is there. Take one shot, I alter aim, and the shot doesn't kill him, and I get pretty much half of my points taken off me. Then I missed the bat chat twice. I prepared my armor rack as I know I will have to make a reload soon. The T-43 is behind me and RT does do some damage, and I'm gonna unload the last shell on the T-43, hoping for a high roll. That doesn't happen. Fortunately, this guy isn't very good, actually it's not good at all, but I managed to break, and now I'm gonna try and break contact. I'm halfway through my reload, and at the end some of my reloads, and I also do this a lot, I tend to finish my battles with uneven clips, like 3 APCR shells, 2 AP shells. Sometimes that has bitten me on my backside. Anyway, I managed to get down here. I auto aim, take out the bat chat, and now another small mistake. I'm not expecting, I just want to keep moving because of the artillery fire. I wasn't expecting this guy here. It surprises me. But I managed to get the kill, and now I've got 4 shells left in this clip. I still have artillery support, so I'm going to scout and maybe take out some SPGs. I didn't take it past the realms of possibility that RT might have been moving down this line, since it looked like the game was much under control at that point, just before the bat chat got killed. So I'm just gonna go to the usual spots. I'm on 7 kills right now, so there was a Pools medal, and well, right now there was a Radley Walters on the table, and there was the possibility of a Pools as well. And my view range is not optimal, but it should be enough to beat any SPG. and we found one there. Auto aim. I spotted the other one. I just kept auto aiming, and I wanted to make sure he didn't rush out of the corner to shotgun me. So I kept looking at it. There's another two SPGs that would have been aiming on me, so I didn't want to stay there for any longer, and I just decided to break contact again. We secured the Radley Walters medal with the kill on the, I believe it was the 212A. And now I'm gonna get to this spot here, try to locate the other two RTs. I'm gonna stop, I auto-aimed and I didn't fend the first shell, but my next two are gonna take the GW Panther out. And now I've got uneven clips, I believe 2 AP shells and 4 APCR shells. And I wasn't really paying attention to the amount of hit points left at this moment. I knew that I had 2 enemy SPGs to kill or to just to locate, and I do end up telling my remaining ally tank or SPG that I have 6 shells total left. I was gonna go around to try and find the other one, and it gets spotted at our cap. I've just finished loading, and I immediately turn left and head back to kill the RT. At this point I realized it was a tier 5 RT that I only needed 1 shell to kill. I didn't realize that there was a tier 5 artillery piece on this game up until this point, where it's actually in my render range and spotted. So I'm just going to assist this guy. I had requested that he didn't light fire. It's a bit pointless. If I was to locate an SPG and he wouldn't be loaded or in a position to assist me. So I take out the LEF, which is always nice because they're fucking pain in the ass. The 207 fired, and we just secured the Pulse medal, and there's just a little bit over 2 minutes left for me either to locate, kill or assist the friendly SPG in taking it out. And I'm gonna play it safe right now. I'm just gonna drive into their cap and start the cap clock. I'm not gonna go hunting, risking the chance of getting killed by the SPG and the friendly SPG missing his shot, which he missed before on a stationary target. So I was careful enough not to break stuff, and I didn't take cover behind one of the tall buildings. Those would be the most obvious locations, so I just hold behind this. If he comes from my right, we'll be proxy spotted with no line of fire. If he comes from the front, he's probably not expecting to see me in a pretty exposed position like I am. So I'm just gonna stay here for the remainder of the cap process. Someone is telling me on chat that the enemy SPG might just try and run, and I reply that I just want to secure the win. I just want to win at this point. There's no point risking the win for an extra kill that brings me almost no profit. So it's a bit of a tense moment. I just kept waiting for that random shell to reset me. And there it is. He blind fired. He won't have time to let go another shot, so I drove forward. Just break a few objects, just telling me, hey, I'm here. And we secure the win. So this was my Ace Tanker game on the 25 TAP. It was high caliber, Top Gun obviously, Pulse Medal for the 10 kills, Pascucci for the 3 SPGs I managed to take out, and the Invader for 100% cap points. 3844 damage dealt, 1381 base experience. I've had better games, but for some reason they were not an Ace Tanker or a win. I fired 25 shells, 20 hit, 18 penned, got just under 900 assisted damage, and even with the premium account, since I fired most of my premium shell loadout, it turned out that I lost almost 5,000 credits. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this battle. Stay tuned for the next days. There's gonna be some changes to the channel, especially the languages used to comment on videos. There's gonna be a trailer as well. And I'll catch you later.